Afghanistan is a landlocked nation bordered by Iran, Pakistan, maybe India, tiny bit of China, Tajikistan, Uzbekistan, and Turkmenistan. Despite Afghanistan having the name the Graveyard of Empires, it was conquered by a lot of empires back before it was in its modern borders, and most notably, the Persians, Alexander the Great, the Mongols, Timur, and the Mughals. Modern Afghanistan's foreign policy really begins with the Russians and the British making the lands of modern Afghanistan into a buffer state between them. Afghanistan did fight several wars with the British, however, but they were able to repel them, hence kick-starting their Graveyard of Empires legacy. Then again, this legacy was re-established with the Soviet-Afghan War, where the Soviets failed miserably to subdue the Afghans. Immediately after this war with the Soviets, the socialist government of Afghanistan was overthrown by the Mujahideen, the rebels who the US supported to fight the Soviets. Despite the Mujahideen creating an Islamic Republic, this was not Islamic enough for the now infamous Taliban to rise up and take control of most of the country. The US intervened to overthrow the Taliban when they realized they were aiding Al-Qaeda. Yet nowadays, with the decreasing US presence, the Taliban has seen a resurgence and the war in Afghanistan continues. With the backstory out of the way, let's get into Afghanistan's foreign relations. Afghanistan's neighbors mostly have a rocky relationship with the country. Despite sharing much in culture, Iran does not get along with Afghanistan, as it is not a fan of America while Afghanistan is. The relationship with Pakistan is not great either, as the Pakistani government was much more in favor of the previous Taliban government in Afghanistan. Despite this, Pakistan and Afghanistan did manage to create the Afghanistan-Pakistan Transit Trade Act. However, recent border skirmishes have since deteriorated their relations. Afghanistan has a decent relationship with its fellow Central Asian countries, as many of them house foreign air bases with the great powers to assist the current Afghan government. Now, do not forget about the small border Afghanistan has with China. Now, relationships are surprisingly good, as despite China being a communist country, it did condemn the USSR's invasion of the country of Afghanistan. Today, China has pledged $3.5 billion towards the investment in the country. In terms of US relations, they are very strong as the US helped to overthrow the Taliban and establish the current government, and Afghanistan's current president actually fled the country in his youth to become a US citizen and later returned to get involved in the politics of the new Afghan government and eventually become its leader. Now, here's an interesting foreign relation. Afghanistan was the first country to officially recognize Kosovo. In terms of who Afghanistan gets along with the most, it would surprisingly have to be Turkey, as there is a saying that no Afghani has been killed by a Turkish bullet and vice versa, even though Timur was kind of a Turk and did conquer Afghanistan, just not with bullets. Anyway, thank you guys for watching the first geopolitical series of each country, and catch us next week with Albania.